Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. I hope that all of you are doing well, and if you're not, I hope that things get better soon. So I actually had a different video planned out for today, but just like my real estate roleplay, it's not as long as I thought it would be, so I'm going to work on it a little bit more to make it a little bit longer. Yeah, because I'm just not happy with time. And so I just thought I'd do an updated makeup video. I've been tired lately and I haven't been able to sleep. And so I thought I would just do something that would relax me. And in the process, hopefully relax you as well. I'm going to try to do a little bit more speaking during the video. Sometimes I feel like my videos when I do makeup are too silent. I don't know if that's good or bad, so I just thought I'd try something different. But I might get caught up in the makeup and then not talk. But yeah, anyways. So I'm going to do a bronzy look, and I'm calling it bronzy because the foundation's a little bit darker, and the way I've been applying the blush makes it look like I have a glow. Well, that's what it looks like to me, and that's what it looks like in the picture, so hopefully it translates on to this video. And I've been doing it for a couple weeks now, and it makes me feel really pretty. So I'm going to do that for you guys today. So I hope you enjoy the video, and let's go ahead and get started with the primer. And I'm going to use my hourglass. Airbrush primer. Just going to put a little bit on my T-zone. I'm going to use the camera. Then I have my mirror right here. This is a really mattifying primer. And it's not hot here yet. Putting a little bit on my oily areas. I have my pregnancy tea and my Harry Potter cup that my daughter got me, I believe, at a yard sale. It's really sweet. The foundation that I've been using that is making me look bronzy is the Mario, Makeup by Mario foundation, and the color is 9W, and the lady tested it on me at the counter, and once again it looked fine, and then I came home and I looked a little darker. I think I've gotten a little bit of a tan, tiny bit, so I think it'll work. It's very nice coverage, but it is a little too luminous on my skin tone, so I actually just put it on the outside. On the inside, I'll put something a little bit more matte. So which one do I want to do? So I'll do this True Match L'Oreal, and I'm in the color natural beige. So I'll start with that here in my T-zone, and then we'll move on to the makeup by Mario. I'll just put it in the back of my hand to warm up the product. I washed all my brushes this past weekend, so they're nice and clean. I think I'll do the Real Techniques puffing brush. I'm just puffing it on my skin. Putting a little bit on my eyelids. Just grab whatever's left and I'll put it on here. I'll try to be gentle. Remember, there was a time where I used to put scotch tape right here to prevent to get your eyeshadow to look a lot better, and people would just put straight up scotch tape on their eye without putting it on their hand first, and then they would take it off. It looked really painful. So, there's that. So now I can go in with the Mario one. We'll see if we need any more pumps. I'm actually having lunch with my friend today, so I'm doing my makeup as well. Because I feel like brushes are so temperamental. Sometimes they work really great, sometimes it doesn't apply the foundation the way you want it to. It's really annoying. So I'm just putting it on wherever I didn't put the other one. think I need a little bit more. Still see my what is it? Scoring. When I was younger, I would wear really thick foundations, like the old school, like Kat Von D type. I'm sure there's a lot of pictures where I look really crazy. Okay. So I don't know if the camera picks it up, but I feel like I look a little bronzier already. Now I'm gonna go ahead and grab my e.l.f. camo concealer. On the back of my hand, and lately I've been using a little brush to blend it out. And it's the Morphe R37. Just gonna put some. I just feel like it blends it a lot better, a lot more natural. Natural fit. Owie. More of a natural finish. See, it's a little bit more matte now. It has a little bit more coverage as well. Very nice. And then I'll put a little bit on here, where I want some light, or I don't know, people do this. The tea's helping me not to be out of breath. Okay, so I don't want to put too much powder on. So instead of going with a powder puff, I'm just going to go with a brush. I'm using my Laura Mercier translucent powder. Used a fluffy brush. I'll just kind of dust it everywhere. Okay. And the eyeshadow that I've done is really fast. It's three colors, but I blend them all together and I put it all over my eyelid and my brow bone. And I use this Wonder Beauty, but they're pretty much light brown shades. So I go into these two light brown shades, and I go into the Revolution Pro Legendary palette, and I go into this other, like a mauvey brown color. I just blend those together and I just do it really fast. I'm gonna grab a Morphe M441 brush. Bring it up to the brow bone. Okay, there's not enough color for my taste, so I'll add some more. Like the camera's really picking it up, but I don't see a lot on here. Okay, easy. So we're gonna go ahead and do the same thing. Blend it together. Easy peasy. Then I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of shimmer, but just like line it on my eyes. And then just any shimmer that you want. Do the same on the other end. If I can. Okay. And then I'll grab a little brush and I just add the same colors to the bottom. I'm trying to control my mouth because it wants to do that. Okay, then we'll add a little bit of the shimmer in our tear duct area. So, I finally gave in to the trends, and I bought the clear gel, that e.l.f. one that everybody's talking about. And I've already tried it, and it looks really good, so this is not a try-on. And I just went ahead and bent my spoolie. And I did my eyebrows the other day. Well, I did it myself, trimmed them, and shaped them with a little razor for eyebrows. And I just grab a little bit. I just pat. Go ahead and brush. It's kind of hard to do because my eyebrows are some really curly, so doesn't look as good as people with straight eyebrows. I mean, it looks good, I just have to work on them a little bit. Still wet. I go in with the color by a Maybelline Tattoo Studio, color black brown. Give me one second. Okay. I'm just gonna add some light strokes. Follow the follow the shape that the gel gave me. There you go. Okay. Now we're gonna do the same to the other eyebrow. This eyebrow always comes out a lot better. You can't see, but there's all kinds of particles. That's because you're supposed to do them on clean skin. Excuse me. the, what is it, natural brown look? I don't know how natural that looks, but I like it. Okay, so now we're gonna move on to blush. And I'll be using this Revolution palette. And the two colors that I've been using are these two. I just mixed them together. They gave me a really pretty See, there's something about it. It's making me look bronzy. Really like that, and I'll bring it all the way up to my temples. Very nice. And now we just need mascara and a tinted lip, and we're all done. And the mascara I'm going to use is the Maybelline Gray Lash. Lots of lashes and very black. I bought this mascara a couple weeks ago. And I've really been loving it. Does a great job separating and lengthening my eyelashes. Look at that. Pretty. I'll just do the same. Remember back in the day, people were putting a coat of mascara and then adding powder to the eyelashes. So it creates that, like, I don't know, thick, wet look. Like Twiggy lashes. If you don't know, Twiggy was a supermodel back in the 60s or 70s. And they named her Twiggy because of her, how thin she was. Maybe your eyelashes too, I'm not too sure. Okay. Now we'll move on to the bottom ones. And I haven't gotten a lot of transfer with this mascara than I usually do with the others. So, pretty good blush. Finish up the look. We're gonna do this Mineral Fusion Sheer Moisture Lip Tint in the color Adorn. Spread it out a little bit. There's my look. Push this back. I hope it looks bronzy on camera, because it's very bronzy. My hair, I haven't washed it in 6 days. So wash day will be tomorrow. Usually usually when I strain it, I don't wash it for a little while. And since now I'm at home, I'm not seeing anybody. I'm not running into anybody. So, who cares? But yeah, there's the look. Super simple without, if I'm not, you know, doing a tutorial, it takes me maybe 15, 20 minutes. But yeah, there's a look. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I should have a role play to you guys by next week. That's if I don't end up hating it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day, wherever you are. And I'll see you guys next time.